Good morning. As we brace ourselves for this cold blast that's coming our way, I trust that you're doing well and we share together today from God's Word. Have you ever heard it said, "I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me"? Have you any idea who said that and where? That's a word from lockdown. Paul was in lockdown in the worst of the worst possible kind. He was in a room chained to a Roman soldier. Read with me. Philippians 4:10-13. I rejoiced greatly in the Lord that at last you renewed your concern for me. Indeed, you were concerned, but you had no opportunity to show it. I am not saying this because I am in need, for I have learned to be content, whatever the circumstances. I know what it is to be in need, and I know what it is to have plenty. I have learned the secret of being content in every and any situation, whether well-fed or hungry, whether living in plenty or in want. I can do all things through Him who gives me strength. Paul doesn't say that he's not lonely. He rejoices that the Philippians show concern for him. He's writing them a letter. He's having an interaction with them. He doesn't say that he has no needs. He has need. He has learned to be content with that situation that he finds himself in, whatever it is. Now, some of you have found that same contentment. I can do this. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. But some of you are restless. I met a lady this week who was walking in the street, weeping, very embarrassed when she saw me. Stiff upper lip. She doesn't want to talk about it. The next morning she phoned me about a totally unrelated matter, and she broke down again. No, she doesn't want to talk. Totally dysfunctional, but won't talk about it. Now, you may not be weeping and be dysfunctional, but the lockdown may be getting to you. Now, Paul says earlier in Philippians, he says, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. It wasn't Paul's nature to be content. He wasn't one who sat down and did nothing. He was a man of action. He challenged the council in Jerusalem on the question of the Gentiles. And he took the mission, he took the gospel to the whole world in his missionary journeys. He was stoned, he was shipwrecked, he was chased out of towns, and he did all of that. He's a man of action. It's interesting that in the King James Version, and it's the only translation that has that in, but in Acts chapter 9, when it gives the account of Paul's conversion, Jesus says to him, "Why do you kick against the pricks or the goads?" It's not in any of the other translations, and I'm not quite sure where it comes from. But on that Damascus road, Paul had an experience that changed his whole life, and it made him have a different approach to life. But it was against his nature to be content and to sit down. But he says, "I have learned to be content, whatever the circumstances." Doesn't come naturally. I have learned the secret of being content in any and every situation. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. So lockdown has taught me many things. I have learned many things. How about you? What are you learning? Maybe you want to make a list of the things that you have learned during this lockdown. Your relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. Your standing in your spiritual growth. What new things can you do? Rejoice greatly in the Lord. Learn from it and experience His peace flooding over you. Lord Jesus, we come to you and we thank you for your peace. We thank you for your purpose. We thank you for the power that is set free in us, that we can indeed say, "I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me." Come, Lord, by your Spirit and minister to each one of us whatever our need. whether we're doing well or whether we are battling. Come and strengthen us, the Parakletos, the one who comes alongside of us to give us strength. And we ask, Lord Jesus, that we would learn to know you better as we go through this lockdown, that we would learn to know you better as we have time to contemplate and to do other things. And so, Lord Jesus, bless us this day, we pray in your name. Amen.
Just as I am, without one plea, but that thy blood was shed for me, and that thou bidst me come to thee, O Lamb of God, I come. Just as I am, though tossed about with many a conflict, many a doubt, fightings and fears within, without, O Lamb of God, just as I am, poor wretched, blind, sight riches, healing of the mind, be all I need in thee to find, O Lamb of God. I come. Just as I am, thou wilt receive, wilt welcome, pardon, cleanse, relieve, because
and so, go into this day with the strength of the Lord. Go with the knowledge that he has prepared the way for you, and enjoy the day. God bless you. And now the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen.